Hello, hello, everyone. Welcome back to another stream. Okay, so guys, we want to create this show in today's mates. Okay, then we will adapt the UVs and we want to export this to Substance Painter to bake the textures. Okay. So once again, everyone, welcome back to another stream. Okay, here we can start the plane. Okay, I'm gonna create a plane here, and apply one of this material. And remove these height segments or these length and width segments, we don't need them. Okay, and we'll convert this into a triple poly. Okay, now I'm gonna add one segment in the center. Okay, connect with one segment and we should move this vertex a little bit to the front. Maybe you can cut a line through these two vertex. Okay. And if I, sorry, if I add this turbo smooth modifier like this, so I'm gonna move this edge down, maybe this much. I think we should increase our width also. Okay. Now I'm gonna add a couple of segment in here, maybe two. Okay, wait, I think we need three segments. I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna select these three and move it outside a little bit. Same here. Okay, I think we should reduce it like this. Okay. And what if I move this vertex a little bit further? Now I'm gonna save a copy, then we'll create the handle. Once we finish the basic layout, we can start detailing the model. So I'll go to the top and get a handle using this spline. I just draw a line. Then we can enable this in viewport. and apply one material. I think we should increase the thickness or radius. Okay, I think this is enough, right? You can actually add thickness into this measurement, okay? I'm gonna duplicate this handle just in case we need it. We need it later. Okay, here we can make sure this is actually in the center. Okay, now we'll convert this on charitable poly. Okay, I'm gonna add one segment here, maybe on around here, and the last one should be here. Okay. Now, I'm gonna select this face. Okay, I think we should increase the total segment on this hand. Okay, we need to go back. I'm gonna increase the size to maybe 18. Now we can add those segments. Back. Okay. Let's connect these two vertex, maybe. We can actually create a complete shape in here. I think we should create a new shape. Okay, just try to model this. Okay, I'm gonna we need to create one gap between the center. Now I'm gonna explore this one, or maybe we should insert a little bit. Then extrude. I think we don't need to insert, right? I will just select this face, extrude. Maybe more like this. We need to check. Yeah, I think we should anyway, we'll try one more time. I'm gonna export this one more time. Maybe you should chamfer this edge. And change some more to maybe quad or trice. So if I apply ASM to modifier, this will be the result. Okay, I think we should create a new shape. Think it's better to create a new shape, guys. I don't know. Maybe we need to connect these two sides. Okay, I think we should create a complete new shape. Don't worry about the edge. So I'm gonna close this gap, then we'll do this one. Okay, I'm gonna go to the sorry, we'll select this line and we'll create a line like this. And move this vertex. I think we need to add one segment here. Let's select this segment and can divide like this. Now we can select this vertex and use this fillet to make a curve in here. Now enabling viewport and change it to rectangular. And apply this material. Okay, here we need to decrease the thickness. Okay, I think we can actually connect these two meshes later. I'm gonna say the copy. No. We duplicate this or a decimal to modify. Okay, now we can add another line in here. And divide with an on segment. Now you can right click this vertex, select this mode. Okay, and change the radial and reduce the thickness. Okay, I think this is basic shape. Maybe we need to increase the size of this. Okay, I'm gonna delete one side. Okay, then we'll try to merge these two meshes together and save a copy a couple of times. Increase the size a little bit. And I'm going to convert this one to a triple poly and attach to this handle. Okay, now we can bridge these two faces, I think. Okay. I think it's fine, we can just hold on, maybe you should move this edge a little bit here, and you can try this again. Okay, let me try this now. I think we don't need all these guys, we can just build like this. It can actually. Okay, let me shoot in this side. Then remove this. Hold on, I'm gonna try this turbo smooth, and it's actually fine, I think. And what if I apply this temper modifier? Okay, I think we need to clear this area. You can actually cut couple of lines like this and delete all these lines. Delete this twice. Control and backspace. See, now it's actually fine. You just need to clear here also. Okay, now I'm going to select this edge and press ring and connect to maybe 4 segments or three. Okay, then you can just connect like this. And remove these twice. And not like this. And change the shape a little bit. It's actually so flat in here. Okay, now it should be fine. We call this delete this. Check the bookmark again. It's actually fine. You can add a symmetry modifier. And make sure actually you don't use this cylindrical shape when you are applying this. It's okay. Oh no, it's actually small, right? Okay, maybe we can detach this. We detach this whole shape. Then add the symmetry. You can delete this one and add a new symmetry modifier. Okay, I think this is so large, maybe you should change the size. So do I think, and move it a little bit to the top, and I'm gonna say copy again. Then collapse all this. Now we can attach these two meshes back. Then just clean this area so we can weld all this back, I think, perfectly. I think we don't need this segment, we can just delete. Control and backspace. Okay, I should be fine. I think we should move all these vertex a little bit to the top. And just down. Okay, the shape actually fine. I think we should create a high poly in here, then make the low poly from this high poly. I'm going to delete this stub adjustment for now. Okay, back here we need to merge these two sides. I'm going to say copy again and duplicate this plate. Okay, we need to cut through here. We'll delete this turbosmooth and cut a line like this and delete these four faces. In here, I'm not attach these two. Okay, and delete this face. Wrong. And I can see the vertex or not. Okay, I think we should add a couple of segments before we merge these two meshes, okay? And I'm going to select this border and scale down. I think we should scale down from this side also. Okay, now we should remove these faces from this side. Then we can weld. These. Here I think we should put the top. Now we can select these or we can just weld the vertex. I think we should do So just delete this face and bend this vertex. Same here. Okay, this face. And use this target build. Okay. And if I actually clear the smoothing group, clear out, add a new one, it will actually remove those black thing we just saw. And in the front, can we so you can select this border and cap it. Okay, then just select this vertex and connect it. And this actually maybe you should connect with these two corners, or we don't need to do that. Okay, now we need to duplicate this plate and move it down, then we'll do the same, or I can do one more thing. You can just select all this and detach it, and I'll delete this. You can add a symmetry modifier. Be exciting. Nope, wait. Actually, see. So, okay, we can move it down. Okay, I think we should just duplicate. No, we don't need to. Okay, before we apply the symmetry, we need to select this whole border. Okay. I think we don't need this pipe border or handle. We just need the plate, okay? And again, hold on shift and extrude it. For this plate thickness, okay? Now, if I turn on the symmetry, I think we need to manually build all this together. I'm going to decrease the thickness And make sure actually you don't have anything in the center or in between this symmetry mode. Okay. Now I'm gonna save a copy just in case. Now collapse one. And we'll just select these two sides and move to the top. Or we can just turn this on. Make sure you actually check this vertex. Okay, now turn it on and you can just snap to this vertex. And don't forget to press Ctrl A and weld all this. And the threshold should be 0.1. Now actually the weld, see. Okay, now I'm gonna move this here. We need to connect these two meshes back. Okay. Let's attach these two and select these two borders and just cap it. And we can remove one. Wait, wait. We need to actually select these two borders, then bridge it. I think we don't need to worry about these small turns, or we can just bend like this maybe. I'll just keep like this. You can just remove these sides and see what happens. I think it's fine, we can keep it right. Yes, it's okay. Okay, I think we need to create high poly, low poly from this high poly. Let's see, apply HM for modify. So this is our high poly mesh, I think. We need to hold this edge. No, I can't do that. Maybe we can just connect. It's actually so sharp, right? Maybe you can. Think it's okay. You can keep like this. So this is our high poly. Now we can apply chamfer modifier, then create a low poly. Okay. Now add this chamfer modifier, reduce the amount. And change it to unsmooth edges. I think we need to clear all these smoothing loops. Then try this chamfer. Oh, everything should be fine. See, we have all these edges. There's something I should go. Okay. Hamid, hi, welcome to the stream. Okay, here. We need to connect these. We have an unused vertex, I think, in this. Remove it. Get more than one. Now we can cut a line same here. Now, if we apply this term, we still have that templates. Maybe we can just remove like this, right? So I think that's it for the height poly. Now we can create a loop poly from this. Maybe you should reduce the size here. Okay, I'm gonna save a copy. I think we need to hold this edge. Okay. Now if I turn this off. Well, so high poly can just we need to attach this thing, right? Okay, now we're gonna save a copy again and go to edit clone, change low. And open the layer or scene explorer and hide this. Hide this high poly. Okay. So this solo poly can actually reduce the iteration to maybe one. This one is enough. Or zero. I think we should keep it in one. And we don't need this chamfer, I think. Okay. Can remove it. I think we need this chamfer mode. Okay, I'll just collapse all this. Convert our table poly and start removing all this. Using to remove all these corner segments. Just press Ctrl and backspace. Okay, then we can remove these random edges. Okay, make sure I actually remove all these vertex. And select and if you are using the 24 version of Max, you can go for the retro topology modifier. Okay, Ctrl and backspace. And make sure you don't have any sort of vertex for. Okay, same here. It is going to take some time, I think. I think you should keep this up. It should be fine. Got to fire all this. We lost the shape in here. I think it's fine. You can just continue selecting. Yeah, I think can just delete all this, okay, and see what happens. Okay, we still have the shape. Just clean this. Maybe you should cut a line through here. Okay, might have some problem. Okay. Hello, I missing. Okay, we need to clean this area. Okay, I'm gonna select random edges. Okay, then remove it. Think we should just clean this area. And we don't need this, I think. Okay, we have one emission vertex. Can just reach it. Okay, I think this is all because of the chamfer modifier we applied. Okay, I think it's almost done. We don't need this one. I think we might need to change the height pulley a little bit later. Yes, I think so. Okay, I think that's it. Okay, maybe you should play in this edge also. Okay, looks like we need to create a new hyperplane. These two sides are actually completely different, right? It so I think we should create a new hyperimage because we made few changes in here. You can create a hyperimage from this one. Just going to clear all this. Okay, I'm gonna save a copy again. Now if I apply a turbo smooth into this, it will be fine. Think we don't need to add a new chamfer modifier, right? Maybe we need to. I'm gonna delete this turbo smooth and save copy and hide all. I'm gonna delete this one, okay? I mean this hyperplane. Then go to edit, clone. And hide this one, select the hyperplane, add this chamfer modifier, change it on smooth edges. Okay, I'm gonna select all this and clear all the smoothing groups and add a new one. No, it should be fine. Actually, you forgot to check this area in our first hyperplane mesh. Okay, we need to hold this edge before we apply this chamfer modifier. not working. Okay, so I think that's it for the hyperlink. Now I can adapt the UVs, then export to paint. Okay, and head on. Control I to inner selection. We can add a unshaped, sorry, unwrap UW. I'm gonna pack all these first. Then we'll start from here. In pip planner में maybe should planner projection and length the same, you know, select this side. In this select like this. And select this one. Now keep planner name or planner projection. Let's see. I think we need to flip this one horizontally and start next. No, back side. Select all this. And we can select these. Okay. Then planar map and let's maybe rotate a little bit. And same here. And select this side here and this mesh. Again, click planar map. Let's see. We can select the inner side. And this small edge. And keep planar map in let's it. Now you can select this mesh. Cylindrical projection. Y direction, and we need to weld all this and that's it. Okay, now we have this handle remaining. I think this is cylindrical projection X and make sure actually click this and let's see. Okay, here we need to select this side. Click planar map again and like it. Okay, I think okay, we have more reds remaining. I can merge these two sides into the sum. Production and length. Okay, that will be fine. I think we should break this edge, then lax it. I think we have one more side. I'm gonna select this mesh. I think okay, it's actually hidden. Okay, maybe you can. Okay, I'm gonna select this edge and convert to faces. Now draw the selection. I'm going to break this and lax it. Okay, and we have these two. Now we do it. Think this is a better way. Lax it, repeat, same here. You can select this vertex, convert to faces, then draw the selection. Click planner map and lax it. Okay, now go back to default shading. We can select all this by pressing Ctrl A and pack all this. Now we can export. These two meshes. We export, export selected. Let's do new folder. And export here. I'm gonna have fed all the meshes. And could have solved this, and we can export this hyperlink. Okay, hold on. I need to. We need to add few small details. So, okay, hold on. I think we should add this once we delete this, save a copy, and I'm gonna collapse all this. Now select this edge. And we can extract this. Then apply this turbo smooth. Now we can see it. You should add a more line. think we should remove this one. Okay, I can export this back. Okay, in Painter we can put a new and add our mesh. has some okay. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, bro, you can sell it, I think. Anyway, Hassan, welcome to the stream. Okay, so our lock poly mesh. I can go to texture set settings, open the bake mesh maps, change it to care 4K. And here we can add our high poly mesh and I'm gonna change the sand aliasing to 8 maybe. I don't need, sorry, I don't know this actually. Okay, you can just play this and we can bake selected textures. Okay, it will take some time to finish. I think we have this small issue in here. And see these sharp edges, right? Anyway, I'm gonna keep like this, okay? It's because of look, probably we need to add a couple of edges here so it will match with the high poly. We need to add a couple of edges. B1, 2. And we need to Then we talk hyperbole, okay? Okay, hold up, wait. We just follow this car and things should be fine. I think rest of the area is fine. And of course we need to check the UV on my track. Okay, we'll just press Ctrl A to select all this and go to tools and lights. I think should be fine, and we can copy again. Export power. Now we can re-import this mesh, which edit project configuration, and select this mesh back. Press OK. And we can bake again. It's actually looking fine now. Sergey, hi, listening. Sergey, Raji, I don't know what. Hey, bro, can you stream? Okay, now it's fine. See, you know how it's small edges, but it's okay. Okay, I'm gonna save this. And we'll close this mix. With layers, we can create a new fill layer. and a group and a black mask. Okay. We need to add two different materials. No, select a metal one first. Now select the mask and go to polygon fill. Change it to maybe this UV channel fill. Select. Select these parts. If you want to select X on the keyboard. Now duplicate this layer and right click on the mask, then invert it. Okay, it will change it to rest of the parts, and we can change the material to a wood. I think we should rotate the material by 90 degrees. And we can scale the material maybe into 4. Okay. Here we can change the wood color. And this metal color. Okay, now you can start adding some scratches maybe. I'm gonna duplicate this metal layer and a mask. Go to smart mask. Then we can add these edge scratches into the mask and make sure we actually change the color. We should change the color, right? Okay. You know, we can add a new fill layer, maybe, and this one. maybe a little bit rust, and we can change the material to this rust. Okay, I'm gonna create a new fill layer here and we'll actually add some dirt. Go to mask editor, we can change the texture to a different one. I think we can rotate this. I don't. Okay, I think we need to rotate the UV maybe. We can actually with this, I don't think we can rotate this mask. Yes, we need to rotate the UV. Or we can just clear this mask. But alphas. Paint with this. Okay, I think it's not gonna work. Maybe we need to. Okay, I'll try to change the color. More like a sand. Hold on, we can add this rust material. And change the color, right? You can delete all this by pressing X. Okay, and I can wait. We just need to blend these two material. Something like this. You know, you can export the textures. Okay, and render with Marmoset 2 by. Okay, you can open. Okay, here we can import the model. Then add a shadow cancel. Go to sky, change to color maybe, and the color to black. And we can start adding the textures. The base color. And the normal map. Okay, this is DirectX one. This one. Make sure you actually flip this white channel. You can see the difference when we flipping this channel. See? Okay, and the roughness metallic, and this ambient occlusion, we need to enable it. This mixer AO, and finally you can add a light. I think you should keep this in the air. So guys, that's it for today. Okay. So if you want to ask anything, you can just comment. Our next stream will be on. Monday, okay. So you can suggest something if you want to see anything. No, next tutorial. Can actually enable this ray tracing and this ambient occlusion somewhere here. And little bit foam. We can save this out. Render. Change the location here. And render. It will be here. Okay. See, I think we need to change the camera position. So how do I zoom in and zoom out? And you don't need this channel yet. Now we can render this again. We can enable a little bit blue. And run the last time. Guys, that's it for today, and our next stream will be on Monday, like I said. We can enable the wireframe front seat. So guys, once again, everyone, thanks for joining the stream, thanks for your support, and we'll see you on Monday, the network will be then, guys. Bye, see you. Bye guys, take care, we'll see you soon.